We're going to do something a little weird today, and as you've probably already figured out from the thumbnail and title, we're going to be redesigning the Walmart self-checkout interface. Now, I don't know about y'all, but anytime I'm at a store and I'm trying to check out, it's just horribly cumbersome, the experience is sluggish, I get frustrated, and I don't understand why companies don't fix this, because sure, they have some degree of attrition due to people that just get frustrated with the self-checkout and then opt to use the standard checkout, which ultimately reduces the overall volume of customers that can go in a given store at any moment. So why aren't they super easy to use, right? Unfortunately, I don't have any source material. I don't have a picture of these interfaces, so I'm gonna go out and get one. I'm gonna run to Walmart real quick, snap a photo, and I'll be back in like 30 minutes to an hour. Hang in there. I'll bring you with me. Mission accomplished. We got what we came for. I will not subject you to a lengthy drive home. Let's just teleport. All right. Oh, that was a bit weird, but we're back. We got what we needed. And as you can see, finally, here in Figma, I've got my little reference picture that I just took at Walmart and teleported back here. And I've also got their brand guidelines that I took from their website. This is the standard blue accent you see all over the place at Walmart, with some light dark variants and some secondary colors for maybe some warning states or something. And they also use this really interesting font called Boogaloo. That's I believe it's a public use font. But either way, it's really clean. It's got those nice rounded edges, and I feel like we're going to be able to do a lot with this when we start getting into the UI. So here we are in Figma. I've got nothing so far. I'm curious to see what I come up with here. Because as you can see from this layout here, there's just lots going on. It's really hard for me to tell what's kind of happening. So I'm going to try and make it better. Hopefully by the time we're done, we'll have something much more clean and easy to use. So strap yourselves in. Here we go. So I actually had a really hard time redesigning this, and I used an old trick that I like to use when I'm designing a single screen for a product. The technique is that you just rank the things that are the tasks that you think a user is going to want to accomplish in order of importance to them, perceived importance to them. And in the real world, you would interview customers to get this. But then once you have that, it's much easier to intuitively figure out how to lay things out such that that hierarchy is achieved in the design. Another technique you're seeing me use here is the strategy of not trying to solve all the problems at once. If you're kind of hitting roadblocks, just get the general structure of the page in place, like simple wireframe, to get an idea of where things are going to be laid out. This often stimulates your creative juices and gets you to figure out how to flesh everything out. Obviously, one of the most important parts of an experience like this is giving users the ability to check what's in their cart, you know, double check what it is that they're buying. So I'm spending quite a bit of time making sure that that's very clear and emphasized to the user. You You'll also notice that I haven't really added any color to the experience yet, and that's intentional. Color is a component that demands a lot of attention from the user, and if you have to rely a little too much on color, that often means that the UX architecture backing your product is kind of bad. So I try to keep things black and white for as long as possible before adding color to move people's attention around the way I want them to move. Having used many of these self-checkout systems myself, I know that my trust in the system is comprised of lots of little trust transactions where I scan something and then I'm shown what I just scanned. And if I see that enough and it's correct, I generally don't really need to check the total because I know that everything's been accounted for properly. So I'm really making sure to emphasize the item that was just recently scanned on the left here. One thing I really liked about the existing design is that big green pay now button that has the number, the total amount I'm paying, in the button. I'm a big fan of having controls say exactly what they mean to do. And in this case, it says exactly the amount. It's saying pay $21. If you click this button, you're ready to pay $21. And that's very clear for the user. One thing that the existing interface lacked was a logical container for all the different ways you can interact with the self-checkout system. Now, obviously, there's lots of different things you can do as opposed to just checking out, like, you know, accessing accessibility controls or summoning an agent to come and help you. But in the existing interface, those buttons were kind of all over the place and inconsistent colors. So I decided to just have everything live in one little space so that users eventually over time, if they're regular customers, kind of learn that the lower left is where the utility buttons are. You'll also notice that all of the buttons, including the main blue call to actions, are much, much bigger than you'd expect for a typical interface. And that's mostly because people at Walmart, you're dealing with the whole spectrum of different folks. You have people that are visually impaired, people with fantastic eyesight, and people can use any kind of interface, but people with bad eyesight can't use some interfaces. They're too small. So I wanted to make this as big as possible so it's as accessible to anyone who comes in the store. Here you'll see me checking the original source design to see that there's that membership banner at the top that's kind of trying to get people to sign up for a membership with Walmart for discounts. And oftentimes I find that the ad banners are a really bad implementation of advertisements. I don't think ads are bad, but they're just very user unfriendly. So instead, why don't we just immediately showcase to the user the value of the membership by giving them an inline discount, showing them exactly how much they would save had they signed up for a membership with a call to action just below it. This is a win for the user and presumably a win for Walmart as well. Continuing down the list of user stories I have there on the right, I'm realizing that I'm still missing a way for people to do some sort of contactless shopping event. So here I'm realizing I need to create a separate screen to introduce users to the self-checkout experience before the actual checkout. Alright, and there we have it. As you can see, it's quite similar to the old experience. I didn't really change anything crazy about the overall architecture. Just kind of tidied everything up a little bit, and I gave the things that had the most priority the most color, and the things that necessarily don't need to take your full attention, they're kind of faded into the background now. So really goes to show you how important it is to get user stories ironed out and rank them based on importance, because then you can kind of use the visual direction or just your intuition as you're designing to figure out where's my attention going, and then does the hierarchy of things I pay attention to match the hierarchy of importance, perceived importance to the user, and you can result in something really, really clean. I hope you... Hope you guys like the process, seeing me go from start to finish. Just want to underscore that this took me a very long time, and I had to kind of redesign a lot of this off camera to really like iron out something that would actually make sense. Let me know if you have any other interfaces you find out there that you think are, again, total crap, and we'll get them sorted out on the channel. But that's it for now. I'll see you guys next Tuesday. Bye-bye.